In this movie, I will demonstrate how you can apply a mirror me transformation, or mirroring operation, to a selection of objects. This is the most simple method of using mirror me, and for this demonstration I have a set of vector paths here as a compound path in the selection in the artwork. I'm going to go to the mirror me tool, and if I drag over this selection, you see an annotation of what the actual mirroring operation will appear like afterwards. I can equally click and drag to specify the angle of the axis, or I can increase or decrease the number of axes by clicking on the left or right square bracket key, like so. Alternatively, I can also go up the keyboard going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc., which also specifies the number of axes. Once I'm happy with how I'm going to actually modify this artwork, I can apply to the selection using three methods. The first one is to click on the Apply to Selection button in the Mirror Me panel. The second one is to use the annotation system, which appears here. And the third one is, if we have the Apply to Selection option enabled as a button here, is to simply press the Enter or Return key. If I go to the Select tool, you can now see the end result. I return back to the Mirror Me tool and perform the operation again using a different method. And I will apply the selection if I rotate the artwork round and pan a little bit using the space bar to pan over the origin of the mirroring operation. And I will apply it using the annotation system here by simply clicking on the Apply to Selection option there. And again, when reverting to the selection tool, you can see the end result. The artwork that has been created is a series of standard Illustrator paths. Where necessary, compound paths have been created or removed. You can continue to edit this artwork as normal using any standard Illustrator or Astute Graphics tool, and there are no further special considerations to take into account.